We're back with more of the Bloodborns. Now, I grinded a tiny bit, so there's our stats.
Grinded.
Well, it's not ground. And also, I bought a new Hunter's Garb. A different version of the Hunter's Garb.
Very nice. How's the stats on it?
Slightly lower.
Lower?
But it looks nice!
Ah, man, why are we wearing it then?
It looks nice! I think it has higher stats against, like, fire. But... not gonna act like that matters. We'll be fine.
Okay.
Fine. So with my new rule, which is a session can only go to like 2 hours, because that's a long ass video, 3 hours. I didn't even edit it. I just like found the bits where I died and switched it off so I could have the text up. And then I just exported it without really editing.
Now, is this that area where all those liquid dudes are?
Yes, we're on the second floor now.
I found him.
We were down there.
Okay.
Last time.
I remember that.
Before we went to the nightmare. And we didn't have a way up here. Now after beating your ghoul, we come up here. Up here is actually the required space of the lecture building. Down there, you don't have to go there at all, I don't think.
Those guys are learning. They're speaking to that chandelier. These guys are out of class. You need to punish them for being late.
Punished. Uh-oh. What the heck was that?
Who's throwing spitballs?
Oh, hey, on the laptop, you see that in the bottom right corner?
Yes.
Hit the claw? No, wait. Hit the 1 hour.
1 hour?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then change it to 1 day. It's going to take a while to load. Just be patient with it.
One day.
1 day. And then hit the clock.
Hit the clock.
There, now it won't bother us for the rest of the night.
Yeah.
And I should update my computer when you go home. I have been absent-mindedly just running around. I don't know what I'm doing, to be honest.
I don't know what you're doing either.
Just fighting slimy dudes.
Yeah, these students, they're not really that slimy. They're just sad and dreary.
Also slimy.
But sweat.
No, it's slime.
That's just the sweat pouring off because of how hard they're learning.
Yes, also slime.
Nah.
Can't get away from the slime, Chris. Oh, hi!
Look at that, he didn't even try to attack you. How dare you hit him? That's abuse. You should be fired as a teacher right now.
Yeah, I could see it in his... Who says I'm the teacher? I just ran into the school and I'm cutting everybody up.
So you're a butcher then?
Yeah.
You're a murderer of all.
Well, I mean, look at my weapon. That's pretty butchery.
Well, that could also be used as like a razor blade. Not for drugs.
That's a close-ass shave. Or not, rather, considering how thick it is. Oh yeah, the other giant that gives me trouble is here as well. There he is. He'll be fun to deal with.
I was watching one of our Watchmen videos, and I came across the boss fight, where one of the guys is like, "Boss, this asshole is mine."
3/3 cords. That's hinting towards the umbilical cords that we need to get. Which we have one of. We need three. The nameless moon presence beckoned by Lawrence and his associates, Paleblood. The moon presence is also Paleblood. Those are the same thing. Those are the two names for the last final boss, the secret final boss.
I guess I can't say anything.
What?
I think I remember what the last boss was.
I don't think I showed it to you.
I thought you did in one of your previous playthroughs. Maybe not, though.
No, I didn't I have not spoiled the last boss for you. I've told you that it makes me unhappy. And when I say the last boss, I don't mean the last boss. There's two last bosses.
Well, that's not even fair.
Yeah, I mean, if you get all three umbilical cords, then it's unlocked. And I'm gonna die.
Ah, you'll be fine.
There we go. Now, you remember Patches?
Yes.
In the forest, he gave us the tonsil stone. We talked to him on the first floor of this building, and he was in the Nightmare Frontier. Always safe from us. Well,
What do you mean, always safe from us?
We were never able to get to him. I mean, we could knock him off the cliff with the... Yeah, that gave us insight. Meeting him. We can knock him off the cliff with a rock, but apparently then didn't kill him. Hey!
Well, this cannot be. You cannot be.
Yes.
Lord Amidala?
Didn't kill me.
How did this come to pass?
I'm looking at your spider butt.
Ooh.
So he gave us that, which basically means we just saw him doing, no, I want to replace, that one.
Yeah, just replace that one.
This is what he just, no, please don't kill me, please, I beg of thee. And you just stay here until you hit X or something. So we're just going to pretend we're not mad at him.
Where's the something button?
Now, wait just a moment.
You said hit X or something.
Oh, that'd be this one.
Okay.
So he's like, you think you're mad at me for trying to feed you? No! Oops, I didn't mean to hit that.
Now you witness to a miracle, and all the stronger for it.
Mm-hmm.
You should appreciate it. If you've a grain of gratitude in you.
You're a dick.
He's a giant dick.
No, he's a giant spider.
Appreciate it.
Arachnid dick.
Arachnid. Adicnid.
Adicnid, I like that one a little better.
Alright. If these videos had titles, that'd be the title of this one.
No matter.
I'm gonna keep talking to you until you give me something, then I'm gonna kill you.
We're fast friends by now.
Sure are.
Let this express what words cannot.
And yeah, he gave us a rune.
Oh, doubt me not, sweet compeer. What is friendship?
Can you hit him?
Very soon. Very, very soon.
I just...
Alright.
Just please murder his face.
Alright, well, I'm gonna unlock this. Well, thanks for giving me the stuff.
That was uncharitably... That was uncharitably done, dear friend.
It doesn't matter. It is done now. That kind of sucks that you can't get... Never mind.
You were saying?
What was I saying?
I don't know. Okay, so... Now we're heading into the last main area of the game. This is the final zone. We're gonna get to right before the boss of this area. And then open up a shortcut to it. Then we're gonna go back and we're gonna go to the two optional areas.
Okay. How many bosses have we killed so far?
Oh man. Cleric Beast, Gascoigne, Bloodstarved Beast, Dark Beast Parle, Biker Amelia, the Witches, Braum, Shadow of Yharnam, the One Reborn. And I think that's it. Amygdala. So like 10?
I think Amygdala was the last one you killed.
I think the One Reborn was. Let me think. Yeah.
I don't remember.
I'm pretty sure there's 15 bosses in the game, and I know we've got like 5. No, there's more. Oh, wow, there's lots of bosses. Yeah, there's baby crying. It's actually not a hallucinatory thing. It's actually in the area, that baby. It's at the end of the area. Ah, I can never sneak up on you.
He just looks like a really, really nice dude.
Mm-hmm. Well, he's gonna... You got the snakes? Are the snakes gonna come out? No snakes?
What snakes?
Usually when I kill this guy, two, like, really long snakes jump out of his body and those try to kill
him. Oh, he's just a giant walking fish. I get it. Oh, man. See? Look at that head. That's definitely a fish head.
Yeah. Totally. Hold on, does this compare? Oh, it's like Revelations 2 all over again.
Yeah.
Only this is slightly better. And let's be fair, grass is hard to do, not like this. And the fact that it looks good from all angles except up is pretty good.
Yeah, because who's looking straight down? Unless you're just that one guy that looks down whenever he walks. Anywhere. Ever.
Or unless you're that guy that checks to see what the grass looks like.
Or that too.
Alright, well, ah, crap. Do you remember those walking brains that would frenzy you by looking at you?
You're afraid of the lights?
You remember those walking brains that would frenzy you by looking at you? There's a giant one in that tower.
Well, why don't you go kill him?
I gotta stay out of its line of sight. Because when that lights up, it means it can see you and you're about to get frenzied.
Huh.
So, I actually don't fight in this area. I run through this area. And I should have put on the Ashen Garb. I'm just now realizing. See, we're also slowly losing health. I'm good. I think I'm out of its line of sight now. But I already have like a ton of monsters on me now, so I'm just gonna keep running until I'm in the safe spot. I didn't lose that much health. That was pretty good.
You can handle these guys. There's only like 50.
And they all throw one-shot kill rocks, yeah.
They'll be fine.
Well, I'm safe while opening this. Oh, he followed me quite a ways. You're in here? What? I didn't know they could come in. What? Whoa! Alright,
oh,
well.
Get up there, man. Get up there all the way. I just want to see how far he goes. I guess you don't.
I really don't. Because there's stuff in the next room that could kill me. So he's getting hit by that frenzy thing. He probably won't die to it, but yeah. Keep seeing him and hurting. Yeah, I see.
Who's he?
One of the monsters.
Oh. So I didn't realize the monsters could be frenzied either, though.
Yeah, me neither. You want to know why I didn't keep running forward?
Why? Oh! Hey, guys.
Okay, so every now and then, I'm able to get through this without aggroing, you gotta kill a couple of them. But... Alright. One. You gotta kill, like, four more, I think. There's a good way. There's a way to avoid the giant one, basically. Come on down. They hit kind of hard. Everything does now, I guess I should say.
Well, I would hope so. Otherwise, this game would be a little bit easier.
Yeah. Okay. So.
Not that it's not easy anyway.
Okay. Does he sweep from right to? Yes. Okay. All right. Chi, rather. So I'm gonna do that. And lure it. Over to where I'm at. It'll find its way.
There's a ladder over there.
Ladder?
To the left. Wait, never mind. It's just...
Wow!
Okay. Right there in the corner.
Yeah, the...
Oh, it's just the bricks. Okay.
Pillar thing.
Alright.
I have been led to believe there's a hunter on that bridge. Not really hunter. Hunter-type enemy. You can't really see him. But I am led to believe that that guy is Lawrence. And he's the guy who was talking to Willem during that cutscene with Viker Amelia. And he was also the guy mentioned in the file.
Okay.
About the last boss. Alright, you come now. After I kill this, I'm going to just try to jump and run to the next area. They will drop, but if you're quick enough, they won't be aggro to you and they won't follow you.
Okay. I guess I didn't pay attention how quick they were.
They're pretty quick. Like, the big one is deceptively fast. And it's not fun. I'm pretty OP right now, if I'm being completely honest. I'm not used to having this high of an attack in this area. There's no more hanging on this side, right? Okay.
Well, that's just the price that you get for grinding like you did.
And run forward. Is it aggroed? It's not. Okay, we're safe from them. I'm just not gonna fight them.
Somebody throws a rock and he comes after you anyway.
Because this guy, I'm led to believe this is Lawrence. Correct me if I'm wrong, anybody. Yeah, the spiders will follow you out onto this bridge. Fighting a hunter and a group of spiders is not fun. Oh, good turn. Oh, jeez, I'm... Oh, wow.
What was that?
That's dust. Or whatever. Oh, you gonna brag about it? Okay.
Killed by dust.
Fine, whatever.
He looks like a knowledgeable man.
I mean, he's leading the school of Mensis. If he's not leading. Well, I don't know. I just think he's Lawrence, and Lawrence is involved in the school of Mensis. You gotta run through that tower thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
And grinding is a good thing, because, probably gonna lose blood echoes when we raid off and stuff. Because we always die in places that the other guy can't get to.
Well, I'm sorry.
Like, I'll die next to a hunter. I'll die between a hunter and some spiders. Or you'll fall off a ledge. and our blood echoes will just disappear. Don't hit up on the D-pad. Never hit up on the D-pad. That's all I care about.
All right.
That's right. Use your cover. Keep an eye on your stamina. Because they got some pretty intense leaping attacks. Alright, I think you're good. And another good thing is the door is already open for you.
Great, so I just gotta kill the one guy that's going to follow me in there.
If he follows you. Sometimes he does, sometimes he doesn't. It sounds like he is.
Yes, I can hear him.
Just make sure you're far enough into the door that the rocks can't get to you.
Right, right.
And not too far into the door that you aggro the spiders. Yeah, I think he doesn't care anymore.
Wow, that's pretty cool.
I hear those rocks crumbling and tumbling outside.
Now, I have to kill the guys up here, don't I?
Yes. Yeah, if you extend it. If you extend your blade, then that would be a vertical attack, and you would be able to hit him a couple times before he gets down.
Where's the crouch button? I wanna...
There's no crouch.
Dang it. I was hoping...
You want a teabag and a disintegrating spider?
Yes.
Okay, so those two are the last one, the only ones that are gonna aggro from you being up here. The other ones you have to hit with rocks or go down to ground level, which I really don't recommend at all. Oh man, I'm really excited if you get through these spiders because I want to see you fight a hunter. You can just run out there. Just be careful not to fall off. Okay, now, get out your axe. Extend it. And while face him. Face 90 degrees from him to the left. If you hit L2, you can do a sweep. That'll keep you from falling off and also hit him, usually. Usually it'll hit him. There you go. Now you can just go to the top of the stairs and wait for him. Can we try out your hammer? I would wait till this one's dead. Oh wow, I thought you had to be next to the stairs for him to come up, otherwise they'd be aggroed to wherever you are. Alright, pretty sure that you only need to get one more on the right. Yeah. Don't be too... Oh. Oh. Oh, that was close.
I'm fine.
Throwing them rocks will send you forward a little bit. Sorry, pebbles.
Come on up, baby. Go get him, tiger. Oop, there you are.
Too bad... She is the most popular out of all of Spider-Man's girlfriends. I'm pretty sure she's my least favorite. Especially the movie version of her.
Woo! I did it. I do things.
I'm a Felicia Hardy man myself. Okay, so that's it. Yeah, now you just gotta... I'd really just book it to the top of those stairs.
Oh, I forgot about this.
Hopefully... don't chase us. Go.
What happens if he gets here?
Okay, he won't fit through, but the little ones will. So just, the big one has surprisingly long range, so be careful of that. Pretty sure viscerals don't work on them.
Ow. Dang it.
With our blood echoes not 100 feet away.
Dang it.
All right. I'm gonna do a stupid thing and I'm just gonna charge through that room. And then I'm gonna try to fight all the small spiders in that tiny enclosure. Because I'm smart.
Can you just like run straight under them and they'll drop behind you? Alright.
Yeah, that's what's gonna happen.
Okay.
It's gonna be fun. I'm just gonna do this to make the frenzy not as bad.
Blue?
There's an item. Did somebody die? No. That was already there. Hey, bye. Alright, I'm pretty sure we're safe now. We will be able to kill that giant brain later.
Now you run a little bit different than I do.
Yeah?
You let your stamina go all the way down. I feel like there's a little bit of a delay if you let it go down all the way.
Mm.
So I always let it go just before it goes down all the way. But that's just my thing.
Sometimes based on if I'm about to be like leap attacked on, I'll like stop halfway through. It's based on whether or not it's safe to stop and all that.
Okay.
I'm just feeling it out. I'm not saying I'm right, but I'm feeling it out. Okay. I'm still gonna take a little bit of a shortcut this way. I'm gonna kill the ones that aggro, the three up here that aggro you just from being up here.
What a dick.
Right? Okay. Let's, can you get out of the way, please? Okay. Oh,
what if he just shot that one?
Cool.
Gosh dang it, you're so lucky every time.
I failed to that before. Wait, are the one that's close to me isn't even following me.
Wow.
He's just on patrol, unless he's coming? Is he? I mean, I might as well. Oh, yep, there he goes. If I just go to the hunter now, he won't. He's not gonna.
I think you're fine.
I think he's stuck against the wall.
It's fine.
All right. Round two. Hold up. Do I have anything that would be? Let's just do some bolt paper. I don't know if he's weak to bolt or fire.
We'll find out here in a sec.
But it's better than just plain. Wow, you got a good turn, buddy.
Wow.
He's fun to deal with.
He didn't even break a combo.
I think that's all he broke. And me. Also me, he broke.
He broke you internally.
Damn.
Okay.
And just knowing that we're gonna play this in a few hours makes me really want to read the books.
Put that. What do you think?
We're on the 10th.
Where's my hammer? How do I get?
Oh, start.
Start.
Would you rather have the axe or the cleaver as your other weapon besides your hammer? All right.
So.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah. I wouldn't recommend a slow weapon against a hunter. But that might do pretty good against the spiders, depending on how much damage it does. I do need to fortify it quite a bit more. Damn, son! You know, these weapons aren't for me, but they got some cool animations. Are you having fun? Oh, that heartbeat, though.
Ah, whatever.
I think you almost just ran off the edge by accident.
That's a possibility?
Oh, yeah. They don't have invisible walls by the edges. You can just walk right off.
Oh.
You didn't know that?
I guess...
That's important to know.
That would explain some of my deaths.
No, you haven't died to that. You died falling down the ladder that one time, but I accidentally deleted that video.
Come in here. Hey!
Oh, I think
I'm trying to...
Yeah. Well. Oh, that's an AoE. Yeah. Oh, damn! I want to heal soon.
Oh! Okay.
I didn't even see him attack you.
I didn't either. I thought he was dead. Honestly, I did.
I thought you had him! I didn't... Cainhurst. Castle Cainhurst, that's the area I was talking about that looks a lot like a Dark Souls area.
Okay.
God dang. Can we please get through this area?
Just so you know, everybody, audience, we do have lives outside of this game.
Well, you
kind of.
This game became my life for about a week when I got it.
I remember. It's too bad I don't have a PS4, it'd become my life for probably a week too.
I remember you said you'd sell your 360 to me if you bought an Xbox One.
Yeah.
But when you buy an Xbox One, I'm buying an Xbox One game.
Okay.
To eventually record at your house or something. A Rare Replay. Because that has Jet Force Gemini on it, which I would record on my N64. But my N64 is a little jacked up. It throws the controller stick off. And it's part of the 64, and it's not a problem with the controller.
Okay.
So I'm just going to record that, and then we're going to do it at your house. I'm pretty sure it's kind of two-player.
Okay. Do you have your hammer?
No, I replaced it with the axe. Why?
I just didn't know if it switched back already. Or, wait, did you already switch it back?
Yeah, I switched it back. You need to stop hitting me so much, buddy.
I didn't realize this guy was so hard to beat.
Yeah, those are the snakes that come out and try to kill you. Okay, they're going to come out. Probably. Yeah, there they are. You just stay over there. Yeah, you just stay stuck in the wall. Wow, it's all lit up in here because the
brains... What if you, instead of going that way, what if you just ran underneath everybody?
Pretty sure everyone would be aggroed on me.
Oh, okay.
I mean, spider's eyesight aren't great, but
You got our blood that goes back from the last time I died, right?
From when you died, yes.
Okay.
And hopefully I can get them from when... Wait, yeah, where did you die?
I died at that first... The snake dude.
Oh, I didn't see him. I bet they were picked up by one of the rock-throwing dudes. Let's be fair, we don't have that many to get back.
No, we don't.
We're not exactly...
Actually, I don't...
Let's actually...
There was like a few spiders worth of...
Yeah, that's not a huge deal. At the end of this area is, like, the best grinding area in the game, so... There we go! About time!
Don't let up.
Well, the reason I stop when they're staggered like that is they have just a few seconds of invincibility. And I don't want to waste stamina hitting them when they have that. There we are. And I'm gonna get that health back.
Ah, there we are.
About time! God!
What would you have done if I would have killed that guy?
That would have been awesome.
I would have surprised myself if I did.
I'm not going to be upset in any way if you do better than me at some parts. I'll just be impressed. Now the next area's monsters are a little weird. Because for the most part, they're not aggro to you. There's one or two enemies in here that are aggro to you, and if they see you, then all the other ones will be. But for the most part, these guys don't care. Unless you, like, get right in their way. Or not. Or if you hit them, then they'll become aggro to you, but for the most part...
Will they all become aggroed if you hit one?
I don't think so. It doesn't seem to be that way. Sometimes they'll just hit me.
Well, that's just free echo orbs, then.
Orbs? Did you say orbs?
I said herbs.
Herbs. Did you say this crap on purpose now? You said echo...
No, I'm sorry. Echo herbs is from a different game. I'm very
sorry. Oh, you've said blood orbs, blood echo herbs, blood storms.
Blood storms? I said that?
Mm-hmm. I remember editing one and you said Bloodstorm, which honestly is a much cooler name. Uh-oh. You know what's a good idea? Yeah, see, now he's aggro to me. Now
dude,
that one
he,
is too. For
he barely
reason.
Has any attack on you.
Oh yeah, these guys are super weak. That's why there's so many of them. They're more of an inconvenience than anything. If anybody has ever died to these, especially after getting to this part in the game, then I don't know what the hell. Right, that guy right there, you see him?
Yes.
He does tons of damage.
Wait, which guy? It looks like there's two of them there.
That's not a guy.
Oh,
that
okay.
Is.
Okay, I see now.
He does tons of damage.
To the audience who was looking at that, I was looking at the black statue down there.
Yeah. Good job pointing stuff out to the audience, because we can't really rely on Tammy for much in these videos, because they're so long that she's probably going to get pretty lazy editing them. Like, I'm pretty sure in the last one we might have told her to do something and she just completely ignored us. Maybe. I don't know.
Well, I think the last time we told her to do something, it was kind of a if you wanted to or not.
Yeah, I'm sure she appreciates that. These guys look like they're from Dark Souls too. Their helmets anyways remind me of Dark Souls. Books.
Those are for learning.
Books.
Although
books,
there is the books. Excessive amount of dust suggests that they aren't really used books. That much anymore.
Books. Oh!
What? Why'd you throw them down the stairs?
I knocked them so far. All right. Books. Books. So many. There's a lot of books.
There's a few.
Quite a few, yeah.
You gonna shake off those that blood?
I don't think. That's just a movement. It doesn't really get blood off.
Oh.
Alright, so this guy can be an issue. He's got a big ol' whip, and he's got a big ol' axe. They both do tons of damage. He's kind of fast.
Doesn't look very fast to me.
Okay, we're good.
What is that? Is that a poison?
Oh yeah, that's rapid poison.
It didn't seem to do very much.
Oh, well, it didn't fill up. If it fills up, then we get poisoned. Then we get rapid poisoned, which is... Oh, by the way, weird thing. Spiders just kind of stuck into the ground for whatever reason. I don't know why. Now, there's only one more of those guys. There he is. But there's also one... there's you and two guys with crossbows. Neither of which are particularly issues, but with him around, they can cause problems.
So as long as you kill those guys before that other guy's aggroed, it's fine.
It's hard. Oh, three guys with crossbows. And I'm pretty sure he'll notice me as soon as I start fighting this one. Yeah.
I don't know why you didn't throw rocks at him.
Good point. I'm not patient. But usually what I do is I just lure him over here, because the crossbow guys won't follow me over here. But he will. Get to a point where I won't fall off. Oh, of course! As soon as I say it, then this is the time they follow. Come on. Good. Yeah, alright.
I'm pretty sure you just barely made it in time.
Oh, yeah. Uh-oh. Yeah.
Ah, very nice.
Pretty sure I don't need... I could probably use the cleaver to finish him off, but he doesn't stagger very easily, so I just want to make it quick.
I would really like to get a PS4 and a 3 and an Xbox One, actually. The PS4 because I want the exclusive games for it, like this.
Oh, blood. Oh, it's... So
is this PlayStation exclusive?
It is exclusive to PS4.
That's what I thought.
The only two Xbox One exclusives I'm in any way interested in is the new Tomb Raider, which, and Rare Replay, just for Jet Force Gemini, which is a great game. Severely underrated. Oh, I didn't...
What did you not do?
I forgot to get a certain shortcut, but we're coming up on another one, so I think I'll just leave it.
There's an enemy. Oh, there they are.
Oh, yeah.
What are those?
Remember the crows and the dogs? Well, they've been spliced. There are crows with dogs' heads and dogs with crow heads.
They're ugly.
They are ugly.
Who creates something like that? That's just...
Well, you gotta remember, we're not in a real place. We're in the nightmare.
We're in a real place. I was real.
Alright, well. Place we're... the place we're in is called the Nightmare of Mensis.
I forgot we were still in the nightmare.
Yep. Almost, pretty much the rest of the game takes place in the nightmare, except for Kanehurst, the castle. And another bonus area. The two optional areas are the only real areas left. The rest takes place within a dream, either the Hunter's Dream or the Nightmare. Nightmare is a big area. It's got a whole tombstone dedicated to it. I don't know.
Bad dog.
We're coming up on a boss that could kill me pretty easily. Yeah, here's the shortcut. It leads down to the beginning. Ish of the area. There's the bridge we ran across.
Okay.
See, right there is the shortcut I skipped by accident.
We didn't skip it because we're here.
It would have been an elevator that led down to here. But I skipped it entirely, and then a new lamp, first of all. Good. So now we're good.
All is well. Nice if your weapons just kind of stick out there.
Yeah, that's not weird at all. Wait, hold on.
Clipping!
Clipping! It's the best.
I remember the intro of Dark Souls 2 was like that. Immediately clipping. In a cutscene.
in a cutscene?
Yep.
Jeez. Well, it's boss time.
That's not a boss.
That's not the boss. You don't get blood, I guess, from killing these guys.
Well, that's not even...
Books! Ming, he's mad at me for knocking his books over.
Nah, it's Chasm. No one does. We shall not abandon the dream. He's not even talking.
This guy is annoying. He's a rough boss.
Does he use his head as a weapon?
No, he has that rain attack.
Oh.
And it kills me almost every time. Which reminds me, I should put on the clothes that have really good arcane defense.
Put your clothes on.
I'm gonna back up a little bit. You can't get through here, right? Right. Cool. I'm gonna put on the clothes that have better arcane defense. Nope. Wait.
Okay. No. Yes. Yes.
Okay. This is the best arcane I can get right here. Shut up!
He's just sad.
Host of the Nightmare. So this guy is basically... I guess they got the nightmare from his head, but even after he dies, the nightmare remains. So, I don't know.
Well, it's just like he invented it, but he didn't die from it. It's kind of like, Thomas Edison. All those inventions.
Okay.
He is now dead.
Oh,
obviously.
Thank God it just starts. Usually, sometimes you have to chase him around those halls for like 10 minutes before he runs into here. And in these square areas is where you actually fight him. It's weird.
What, he runs to other square areas?
There's two. Okay. Get him down to half health in here and he'll run away. So this is easy, because he doesn't have the rain attack when we're in here. Just the tentacle attack. That is more or less easy to dodge. Okay, fine, I'll just attack you then.
It's amazing they don't die from blood loss immediately.
Well, it's important to remember, this is not real. This is a dream.
Well, any enemy in this game.
Any game, really. That involves us, anyways.
Yeah, alright.
Yeah, see? Can't really cheat it either and keep him stunlocked, he just disappears. Now he's going to this next area is significantly harder. Because he has the fucking rain attack. I'm gonna use bolt paper on him, try and make it go quicker. Not too fast. The nightmares should we go downstairs and try to get the better rune? Let's try to get it. This guy's a trap, but if you get him fast enough, it's fine. Yeah. Because you'll chase him down the stairs and run right into a couple of enemies. He's got chunks. Okay, you both got cat and nine tails. Don't see those very often.
Oh no.
No. Yeah, they hit.
Oh my gosh.
Everything hits so hard, man.
Those guys are a little bit tougher. What?
yeah, okay. Collision is not good for that weapon in this hall. Nope. If I can get one dead, then we're good. Okay.
There you go. Yes.
Alright, and then there's a guy with a crossbow and one of the big dudes. This is... We're not even advancing in the boss right now.
I don't even know why you don't throw pebbles. I throw so many pebbles.
You throw quite a few pebbles.
I would be out of pebbles.
When I was grinding, we filled up on pebbles. The game wouldn't let me pick up anymore. So this is rough because he's got a crossbow. So I'm just gonna... And he won't come towards me. So I'm just gonna get this guy aggroed. And then I'm gonna get out of his range.
Did that Molotov?
I don't know how Molotovs do against these guys. Oh, not great.
Kind of tired. Oh my gosh. Kind of tired of that one guy screaming.
Gonna keep going till he's dead. Jesus.
Oh. Ouch.
I'm just gonna go back down to a flat-ish area. He's higher up. It's actually easier to do this when they're higher up. There we go.
Nailed it.
Let me get that health back.
Oh, get those intestines.
Yeah, man. Yeah, see, I didn't need to get the axe out for those ones. If you don't want to listen to him talking, I can just mash through his dialogue every time he starts talking. Not when I'm busy fighting, though. My mind is preoccupied when that's going to... Man, if I get this guy on my first try, I'll be very pleasantly surprised. What is this?
It's the moon.
It's a better moon room. We get apply that and we get even more blood echoes for
enemy. No, it's just the moon.
Yep.
You gained the moon, you dropped the ball. The moon, I mean. The moon is the ball.
Mm-hmm. There is one more moon rune in the game, and it is the best one. And it's actually still in this zone.
Is it called the biggest moon?
No, it's just called moon.
One of Jupiter moons?
It's a little bit, tiny bit embarrassing to admit, but I wrote a Doctor Who fanfiction, and it took place on one of the moons of Jupiter. which moon was it? I think it was Phoebe. You know what? Not embarrassing at all, because I feel like it was actually pretty good. I had a pretty good twist in it. It was not your stereotypical crappy fanfic. Alright, so, back in the halls, there he is. Every now and then you can hit him in the halls, but it doesn't really matter. Oh, is he just going straight? Wow, he's moving so fast! I love it! If he just goes to the left, if he goes in there, yeah! This chase boss basically had no chase in it. That's amazing. I'm very happy. Now, as long as I don't die to him in this next area. Which is very possible. So, the reason I didn't chase him is because, like, if you chase him, a gate will fall between you and him. So you gotta come over here and fall down on him. Now, it's really tempting to do a drop attack on him, but he'll dodge it and then attack you while you're stunned.
Okay.
I'm gonna try to stay up on him a lot, because I don't want him to do that rain attack.
Just think of how active your character has to be able to do all that.
Right? So, she's so...
I think you're gonna get it.
Don't jinx me, man! Okay! Alright! Oh, man.
Calm down.
This is one of the most annoying bosses in the game. Oddly enough, my first time playing the game, I got him on my first try. Now, that's actually an important piece of dialogue to remember.
Mensa's cage?
Yeah, I got his helmet. Now, this is cool. One time I was able to stunlock him and I killed him in the hall.
Okay.
And it gives you a different cutscene. Because here it's showing you in the square area.
Yeah.
It's very, very slightly different. But if you kill him in the hall, then it'll just like do a little bit of a zoom through this big chamber. And then like the second shot is identical and it's the same the rest of the way through. But it, like, I'm amazed they put in that effort instead of just warping my character model to where I should have killed him. Because I'm pretty sure you're not supposed to kill him in the halls.
But if it can be done, then...
I'm amazed at myself that I did it. It's hard, hard to stunlock him. Especially in the halls. He's a quick little booger. You want to see what that looks like? After I take care of this guy? Take a look at that. After I put on my better clothes. Alright.
I don't like it.
I like how it has. I got like a raccoon mask pattern from all the blood. And the rest of my face is clean. I used to think that was clipping. No, that's just an open space in the cage.
Yeah, I noticed that when you first had it on. When he had it on.
Yeah. Now, I'm gonna head downstairs and grab some stuff. Normally, he'd be running from you and you chase him through the area, which would lead you down here. Where you can get this cold blood and that key over there that it's not really an important key because it just leads to an area you'll die at.
What do you mean die at? Like, there's a trap there?
Sort of. It leads to where you're getting to the giant brain.
Okay.
But it's on the wrong side.
Oh.
It leads to an area where you won't be able to have any effect on the brain, and the brain will just kill you.
Death.
I know where I'm going. Don't worry about it.
I kind of figured you did, after 7 playthroughs.
I still get a little bit lost in these halls sometimes. Okay, we're out. And there's a lamp. We never have to go through that bullcrap again. Yay!
And then that hallway drops and you die. And you have to start all the way over.
I was worried about that. Because this is the same bridge that we walked across to get to the boss.
Oh. I don't recall.
Well, we didn't walk across it. There was 2 bridges. We took the one to the side.
Oh, okay.
That's why I don't recall. Oh, shut up. Oh, there's a dog in there.
Minuscule. Absolutely nothing.
Oh, this is fun. Okay, can we see them from here? Well, there's something not fun on that bridge.
But you said them. That implies that there's plural. Yeah,
there's like 3.
I
saw something?
Turn to the left, just Ted. Nah, I didn't see anything. Just the grass moving.
Can't see them. But they're there! Brains. We're actually about to run past them now. We don't fight them. I don't fight them. I just run past them. Oh, look, they're bringing Shadow of Yharnam back as a normal enemy. That's fun.
Oh.
So this leads back down to, like, the very... See that down there?
Yes.
Yeah, so it's bringing it full circle. But this cage is broken and doesn't close. We're about to go into a tiny little bonus area. And it's actually hard to do this. Okay. I've died to that quite a few times.
So like you just miss and then you fall?
Mm-hmm. Better frenzy resistance. Doesn't have better... Better frenzy. Alright. Gonna run past a couple brains now. Which is why I should probably get out my sedatives also.
Inflicted organ.
That's a chalice dungeon item.
Now, can they see you from whatever angle you're at?
No, but they got some damn good hearing. Wah! Which way are you gonna go? Okay. And then I'm just gonna do this later. Oh, she's chasing me. Oh no. Oh no.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
We're good, we're good, we're good, we're good.
I don't like the noise she's making.
Good, we're 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 good. Oh, sedative, sedative, sedative! Okay, we're good. Oh yeah, these are the same species that Patches is, by the way.
I see this.
Yeah, running away from brains and then you just run into a room full of these. It's not great. Oh crap, I might be in trouble. Nope, she's walking away. These guys are aggressive. As hell.
I want to call them Steve.
All of them?
Yep.
They are just collectively Steve?
Yes.
All right, cool.
Many Steves.
Oh. Ah. It'd be better if that had not missed. just gonna say that.
It's the Steve army.
Okay, we're good.
The Starmie.
You are distracting me, sir. In a critical part of this game. Alright, well, that giant brain is no longer a problem.
Isn't this whole game critical?
Yeah. Not the witches. Even though I died to them twice on my playthrough.
It's okay.
Alright, brain, giant brain, prepare to meet your doom.
Oh, look at that cutscene. Dropping the brain. Oh, you just murdered it forever.
It's alive, but it can't see me. Alright, so there's 2 spiders and a brain down here. I'm just gonna book it. Because that item in that chest is not worth it. It's a multiplayer item, and I don't have PS Plus. So right here is where the brain would have been.
Any donations to Joey would be awesome.
They have no way. First of all, no, don't do that. Second of all, they have no way of doing that.
So?
It would be awesome, though. Just, hey, money, why not, right? Trump, get on it. Alright, the key that we picked up...
So what we do is we get Firewolf merchandise going.
Oh, yeah, we need to actually make the album. So the key that we got would have opened this door. So we would have walked in this way and the brain would have still been alive. He would have kicked our ass. Like, we would have died of frenzy in a couple seconds.
Oh.
It's pretty intense, because we're really, really close to him now.
So the closer you are, the more hardcore the frenzy.
It seems to be that way. With this brain, anyways, I don't know about the other ones. Probably. So we're about to get the only blood rock in the game.
That'd be really funny if you fell face first.
The blood rock. And that will fortify your weapon as high as it will go, to level 10. And now we're back here.
What were we going to use the blood rock on? The cleaver?
Yeah. Because it's the weapon we use the most.
It's the weapon you use the most.
Okay, so this is the shortcut I accidentally missed. We're back in that area now, by the way. Before the boss, even. Recognize this area?
A bit.
Well, it was where we started the books.
Yeah.
Yeah, down there, and here's them. Let's go pay the brain a visit. Wait, never mind. I don't have make contact.
What?
I'll show him to you, but to be able to get that last rune, you need a certain gesture that I don't have. And we're not going to get it until, like, the very, very end.
I didn't realize gestures were for anything important other than just fun.
For the most part, yeah. Go pay a visit to our good friend, Mr. Brain. It's also quite dark down here, in case you couldn't tell.
Well, you have a torch that you can use. Wait, turn. Yeah, I see it right there.
Oh, man. Yeah, it helps out a ton. This looks cool.
Can you kill him?
I can, but I'm not going to until I have that hair. I'm not gonna kill him until I have the gesture that lets me get the rune from him. His eyes follow you.
Do not let me drink another energy drink after this one.
Yeah?
Because otherwise I'll start freaking out.
Alright.
Last time I did. And it was weird.
Okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and head back to the lamp.
Because the next day, I was like, I wasn't shaky or anything, but I was wide awake all day long.
Sounds like a problem, I guess.
I didn't want to be wide awake all day long. I wanted to just chill.
All right. So this is after the... Okay, I'm going to head back to the dream and upgrade.
Yes.
I don't want to lose these echoes now.
Yes! No!
All right. Okay.
Yes.
There's not much left of this area at all. Oh, using the blood rock. Boom! Highest level it can go.
Yes.
Yeah, all right.
Can we not fortify anything else now?
No, not right now. We don't have the bloodstones for it.
Dang it!
That. Hey Garmin, how you doing, man? Now let's get rid of some of that inside.
You young kids just like to run around and kill things.
And knock all my books. Well, he was the first hunter. He was the very first hunter. Actually, yeah, let's buy some of these. Because we need these twin bloodstone shards, and they're not giving us any because we're past that area, but we need them to fortify your hammer.
Yes!
There we go. Now we need chunks for your hammer.
Chunks.
Which those are far more common. We don't need beast blood pellets, or elixir. We're done with the knives.
No.
These two. I'm gonna use those. Don't use these. These are Chalice Dungeon items. Cool. I don't use this one. I'm gonna keep these three items because they're really good arcane defense, which is good against the hardest boss in the game for me. There's the better moon. I'm gonna go play that right now.
Vernace.
Boom.
No, moon. Yeah, you know what I did right there.
Yeah, I know. Alright, now we got plenty of blood echoes. Upgrade with. What?
Very well. I desire many things. I desire to be beautiful.
So, strength has just hit the soft cap. We could have put it up further, but it hit the. Putting it up won't actually give us as much of an advantage as starting again on skill would.
Okay.
We can do that.
What's the max level cap?
Farewell, good hunter. I think it's 99.
Okay.
I mean, dude, I'm on New Game Plus 2 and I still haven't. So, still working on that. It gets ridiculous. Where are we going? We're going here. We're going to go through the rest of this area until we get right before the boss. Then we're going to go back and we're going to visit Canehurst, which is a pretty boring area with a pretty cool payoff. Like, it's got a pretty...
Like, it gives you money?
No.
It gives you bloodstones.
It's just really interesting. It doesn't really reward you at all.
Blood echoes.
Well, you do get blood echoes out of the deal. And maybe it's just boring to me because I've done it so many times. Like, Yargul in the forest, I don't like very much.
You didn't catch this because it's already in the game, but I meant to say blood echoes, and I replaced it with stones.
Well, I mean, there are bloodstones in this
game. I know, but that's why I said you didn't catch it for
that
reason.
Oh, jeez. So yeah, these guys are significant.
Oh, he could be a circus performer.
He could. These guys are significantly weaker than the last time we fought them.
Well, of course, circus performers can't do anything.
Jeez. Sam is a circus performer.
Sam.
Australian Sam.
Really?
Yeah.
He's an awesome guy.
He can do
a lot of things.
I miss him. He was very talented. It was weird. Freaking Australians.
Nah, awesome Australians.
Yeah. Go outside and the world tries to kill you. They're like, whatever. So there's three pigs in this area. This is right here. These three pigs and those Shadow of Yharnam guys are the best grinding area in the game, which makes sense because it's like the very end of the game. Now you didn't see it because you didn't turn around, but these pigs look significantly different. They've got many eyes. We'll see it on the next two. I'm gonna try to aggro just one.
Throw a rock.
Alright. Now I need to be really careful because that charge attack can just take me out in one hit. Alright. We're fine. Uh-oh. We're fine. Okay. And we're good. Okay. My TV audio is all the way down, right?
I don't know.
I thought I heard a little bit of a... Okay, we're good. That would have sucked.
It might have been from my headphones that you heard it.
Possibly. I think it was just a weird after. I don't know what it was. But anyways, it would have really sucked, basically, if the TV audio was on.
Why?
Mike would have picked it up. And it would have been really bad. You just turn around. Turn around whenever you want. Alright, you know what? You're close enough. I can just get up on you. Do your attack. Oh, or do that. Yeah, that dummy.
He doesn't know things.
He doesn't.
Now all is known to him.
So one of them is like 15 or 16,000 blood, I think. Yeah. And they give you quite a few. So what's left? What's left? We got quite a few Yharnam shadows, like 4, 5, left, and there's a couple down in that area.
I only see four.
Yeah.
And I'm not talking about the bombs, C4.
This is rough, this is rough. This is a really rough part. I might die here. Oh, jeez. Whoa!
Now...
He's hit. Okay.
Do they incorporate the fact that the enemies can damage each other?
No.
That would make this game a little bit easier, I think.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people would use that, like me, to an advantage. As what?
It's really fun to do that. Okay. And every time you kill one, it's just it's a load off, because it's way easier to manage one than three. And I missed that. There's only one left in here. You see, these enemies are not a problem, but in numbers, they are a huge problem.
Right. That's to be said about any enemy in any game.
That was a sentence.
Yes.
That was a sentence you just spoke. Okay. Okay. The rest of the area is easy.
It was an effort at a sentence.
All that's left is one shadow of Yharnam that will notice me, but I'll be right up on him. Hi. And then that one, that guy, he doesn't even care that we're fighting. He's just looking out at the beautiful scenery.
So you can visceral him, can't you?
Very easily, yes. I've never actually fought this guy. Never once have I seen this man's face. So.
I don't think you've seen any of them's face.
Well, you know what I mean.
I don't.
That's pretty, though.
It's mountains. And fog.
Just a panning view, and then you're in this fucked up area.
You're in a castle.
Go get a bonus buddy, get some chunks from him.
Ah, the
That's
moon
bright.
Is bright.
That is bright.
It's like somebody put a flashlight there. A moonlight there. Whoa.
Oh, three.
Yay,
nice.
Chunks.
Nice, nice, nice. Probably gonna upgrade the axe before we upgrade the hammer.
Bloodstone chunks. That's like scabs. Nasty.
You know what? I never thought of it that way. I just got...
Bloodstone
blocks
chunks?
Blocks of scabbage in my pocket.
And then you got a bloodstone rock?
Like the blood rock. Yeah, it's just a good
rock
fist-sized chunk of dried up blood. Ugh, gross. Alright, well, hey, Yharnam. She's crying, and the baby we've been hearing crying this whole time is right up that elevator.
Okay.
And it's safe to assume that it's her baby. It's Yharnam's baby.
Well, considering she's... Why is she gotta bleed? She's got shackles on, too.
Yeah, I used to think she was just, like, praying or something. I never noticed that. So I still gotta know more of the lore, but yeah. Right up there is the boss.
Can you kill her?
I've never tried, and I'd rather not.
Do it.
I'm gonna unlock the shortcut first. Just in case it turns out very badly for me. Also, since you're convincing me to do this, this doesn't count as a death.
Okay. Alright. That's fair.
Alright, please don't... oh, wow. I thought she'd be a lot tougher. I feel bad. I didn't even get blood echoes or an item, so I feel legitimately bad about that.
What if that changes the story?
Oh, that'd be weird. I don't think it would, though. Oh, yeah, I forgot. I put it down. Well, come back up. So, yeah, right up there is a boss. And after you beat that boss, you can go straight to the end. That boss leads, like, one boss after the other. That boss and then the last boss.
Okay.
So we're just going to unlock this shortcut. Now we're going to go do the two optional areas. First one is Kanehurst. Really easy, quite boring. And then the other one is above Odin Chapel, actually. And it's nowhere near as boring. But it is very difficult. That's why I always save it for last. When I'm as high level as I can possibly be. So you remember when we went to Yosefka's clinic? And we picked up the Kanehurst summons.
Yeah.
It's like, yo, come to Kanehurst. Well, let's use those summons in a place you would never think to use them. We're gonna go to Hemwick.
Oh.
The witches go into the witch's house.
Did you do research on this?
There's no way I found this on my own, man. I was getting towards the end of the game, and I looked up how to get to all of the bosses, because I wanted to beat all the bosses on my first playthrough.
Okay, okay.
And there's a boss in Canehurst.
You want to put this over there?
Yeah.
There's still two left.
Oh, you drank two?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you only had one so far.
No. That's why I said don't let me drink a third.
Understood. Hey, you remember this area?
The spiders.
No.
Oh, no?
The okay. Witches.
Oh, ooh, yeah.
Ah, memories.
I didn't like... Yeah.
Memories, memories.
It wasn't a problem for me, because you were the one fighting them.
Wow. Oh, yeah. This is an earlier part of the game, so they're all significantly easier. It won't be that way when we go to Canehurst. There is a little spot right before the castle in Canehurst that's quite rough, actually. All the mosquitoes. Oh, damn. Oh, he doesn't even hit that hard. Wow, this is... Uh-oh.
Yeah, but many successful hits means your death.
Shut up, I got him. Okay, if I could just visceral you, that'd be great. Visceral, visceral, visceral. Damn it. There we go.
You did it, just barely.
Yeah. And if he has vials, yeah, okay, and I'm full on vials, so I profited from that situation overall. Oh.
Okay. All you did was regain the vials that you used fighting him.
Pretty sure he came in here. Well, yeah, but I also got an extra one that went into storage.
Okay.
So I did profit. Also blood echoes. And I don't really count losing bullets as much of a big deal, because, like, this game is full of... Okay, just bring the summons to this statue here. And then...
Now we wait.
Because you can actually see Canehurst Castle from here. You remember the little broken bridge we walked on to get an item?
Yeah.
This takes you across the broken bridge somehow.
Well, it's a death chariot.
Yeah.
With nobody in it!
Whoa!
And the ribbons on the handles.
Crappy part about this is, I didn't know it, and then, you gotta get on, you gotta get on, you gotta get on. Because the first time I did this, I was being chased. And I thought, oh, the cutscene's activated, I can just get right on, but then it made you get on. And I got hit, like, twice, I think. Now, I tested it, and, if you hit the horses, they'll just die.
Really?
And you have to, like, go back to the dream and come back for them to come back, and you go through the cutscene and everything. Yeah.
So it just takes a lot more time.
It's completely pointless. You don't get anything for it.
Pretty
sure
you don't
get echoes. Onwards to Canehurst.
To the Royal Palace.
Yeah. Pretty sure we're going to beat this game in the next session.
Most likely.
We got two areas left. It's snowy now, by the way. So this will be nice because, like, the actual visual representation of this will influence our brains a tiny bit, and we'll feel colder than we are. And considering how hot it is, that'll be nice.
Yeah. I'd rather feel cold.
Just don't, like, pay attention to it, otherwise it won't happen. Though I probably shouldn't have mentioned it, sorry.
I'll forget about it in the next minute and a half.
See how Dark Souls this looks?
No.
It's very Dark Souls looking.
Okay.
I haven't even played Dark Souls. The horses are dead.
Why?
And it looks like they just fell over. You can see Yharnam from here. I'm pretty sure that's the clock tower the dude was shooting me from. Man, this game is freaking awesome. What? Oh, okay, I thought that was an area that you could drop down to. I was like, have I discovered something?
And then you drop down and die anyway.
Yeah. Open. Thank you.
Open says me.
And here's a lamp, and, well, this one area of Canehurst is pretty rough because of them.
What are those?
Giant mosquitoes. Big ol' mosquitoes.
Sounds like it sucks.
They will work their way up.
Pun intended.
God damn it. They will work their way up the hill, and every once in a while, somehow one is able to sneak behind me, so... And keep pay to- yeah, here he comes. Here he comes. G, rather. I think they're all girls. And their attacks are rough. Man, it's just,
I can see why you said that they're girls.
Yeah. And right here. Come on. Damn it. No, I'm good. They don't stagger. That's the problem, is they don't stagger. And my playstyle relies on stagger. I'll be fine as long as I'm careful and I keep it to one at a time. Let's try this. Ah.
Well, that didn't work.
One more try. Yep. Well, I mean, it went better. Come on. And they can stagger me. That's the problem, too.
Because then you just get stunlocked.
Mm-hmm. Stagger and stunlock are basically the same thing, just on different...
That's your enemy.
Yeah, stunlock is you. Stagger is them. When it's stagger, it's a strategy. When it's stunlock, it's bullshit. If I don't... I mean, there's like four of them over there.
Top it off.
No, yeah. Never tried to visceral these guys. It'd be very dangerous to try. Hey. Hey, between the statues, they can't fit through that. Ah, crap. They learn. Oh, jeez, man. Oh, I'm stuck. Okay.
Have you ever tried jumping towards them?
Oh my god.
There you go.
God.
Secret learned.
Oh my god. Damn it. Well, that won't be very much help against these ones because there's a number of them and I gotta like lure them away. But yeah, I'll try that on this guy next.
You know how to throw rocks.
Oh yeah. I keep forgetting I have pebbles. Hey, bud. Ah, jeez. Okay.
Ooh, visceral.
No. I don't have the time to charge up an attack to get a visceral. I've never been over here, I don't think.
Now you have.
Nothing missed. Eh. That just keeps an enemy from healing. I should have kept, like, one of those to use on Viker Amelia. They're gonna stay down there. We're fine. I'm not gonna go down there to fight them. Alright, what's the best way to do this? Okay, so there's two that'll fight me normally. Yeah. Or rather, a Molotov. That'll get their attention and damage
them. Don't you only want one's attention, though?
Yeah.
There you go. I didn't realize that it would... I figured they'd notice the fact that there was a Molotov thrown.
Sometimes. Well, I mean, they're too far away from each other, really. Okay. Well, now we're really far away from them, so I can just,
Visceral.
I don't have time to charge up an attack, man. You want to see a visceral attack? I'll try and get a visceral attack on the fat one, because he's really slow. That one right there. Come on over here.
No need to throw the Molotov, I guess.
Whoa. Okay, sure. Oh, so now you stagger. Okay, can I get... a visceral attack on you? Like, this one just runs away from you. Hey, look, I'm a thing. Okay, I'm just gonna attack you. Run away from me.
He's gonna fart. Look out!
It's trying to get away. Alright, can I visceral you? No. This is gross, by the way.
Yeah.
Alright. That's the most of these I've ever cleared out. Why all the numbing mist? Nothing in this area heals itself. I think. I'm pretty sure.
Well, I guess if you think about it, if they're like mosquitoes, maybe they can.
Perhaps. Oh, man. There are tons of enemies in this area.
What's up with the woman?
Yeah, these aren't immediately aggro to you. But,
she's just trying to clean the floor.
Well, she's got blood echoes. Candles!
Why did you break the... Oh man.
Candles!
Man, that's like a year's
worth of... Ghost ladies!
Where did she... Oh no!
They're invisible.
She doesn't look invisible to me.
Wow! I'm not used to my attack being this high. This is nice. she didn't look very invisible to you. It's because they don't, you can't see them until you get, like, a certain distance into the room, and then they become slightly visible? I don't know. I don't know the parameters, but,
I see them very well right now.
Yeah, it's because they're aggro, and they're fighting me. They're not hiding anymore. Lots of them. And they give you hardly any blood echoes at all. Part of me wants to... Yeah, let's do that. Let's just run through this area. Let's not fight them. I grinded enough that we can do this, like, once a session and just skip an area.
There was another woman crying in that room.
Oh yeah, that's all these ghost ladies. They're doing that. Now, if you could just... Thanks, because I need whatever's in that chest. Also, top off my health? Thanks. Not topped off, but it's better.
Nearly.
Oh, I'm going to have to run past them. What is that? Noble dress?
Noble dress of nobleness.
It's better blood defense, which is nothing. Oh, you won't get shot as hard. Oh, because getting shot is what kills you most often. Oh, they're wrecking stuff in there.
Usually, getting shot would kill you, yes.
Oh, these guys, they blend in pretty well.
Wow, I did not see him.
Yeah.
You're right.
They blend in very, very well. There's one up there.
Hits.
He doesn't matter. You're not blending in very well. Oh.
He's just an old decrepit bat.
Mm-hmm. Oh. This one usually gets me. Right here. Usually don't see him.
Tits.
Why do you keep saying tits?
I just keep saying tits.
Oh. Because tits. How detailed is that? Let's find... Whoa, what? Where did you come from?
He came from next to the woman with the tits.
As opposed to the woman without the tits?
Fair enough.
Mm-hmm. Hi.
He seems okay.
Okay, cool. You have something?
He's dead.
Yeah, you got vials.
Ooh. You needed those.
How much worse defense is it? 50? Whereas this is 110. Whatever.
Aww.
Let's go at it for a while with this.
You're beautiful.
I really am. I really... this is what my Sunday night looks like.
Yeah. Just like my 8th birthday.
8th? Jeez, man.
I don't want to talk about it.
There's two of them down there. I'm going to skip them. This area is rough. Because we got ghost ladies that'll rip their own heads off and stun you and all that jazz. Bio blood register? What the hell? Oh, that's a multiplayer thing. That leads back down to the first area. So...
I can see those ladies. They are very visible.
Skipping these girls is actually kind of a bad idea. Because there'll be a part in this later.
Evelyn?
That's a gun.
What kind of gun?
I don't know. I don't think I've ever leveled up Blood Tinge high enough to be able to use it. So, am I safe right now?
Yes.
I think so.
For the next at least 15 seconds.
All right, Evelyn. Yeah, I can't equip it. My Blood Tinge needs to be 18, and right now it's 6. And I am not putting 12 upgrade points into something we're not going to use.
Might have to do a little bit of research and see if Evelyn's worth it.
Yeah.
Ouch.
Yeah, I'm skipping so much, which is honestly just a terrible idea.
Why?
Loss of blood. I can hear that guy using a blow dart. But I am long gone, so... Oh. There he is.
Okay.
Oh, I knocked him over. That's weird.
Alright.
Oh! Oh! Okay, alright. Alright, in here? Yeah? Or is it that way? It's that way. What's in here?
A room.
Yeah, there's a chest in here. I'm gonna try and just book it to the
chest.
There's
women. I can see them. I can see them all. There's like 3 of them over here.
I've died here before.
Who's screaming?
That scream will stun you.
Use your invite.
That scream will stun you and hold you in place like the Redeads from Zelda. Executioner's gloves.
She needs to use her inside voice.
Right? The ones without heads are the ones that stun you. Okay, we're good. And now we're gonna do something quite unintuitive.
I wish they wouldn't yell.
Yeah. Are you guys coming?
They hate you. You almost fell. I think you would have been okay.
Oh. I meant to stay out there. There's some stuff you could get. This is why not killing them is a bad idea. Because they're right behind this. And that one right there, if it notices me, which I don't think it is noticing me right now.
It is.
No, no, not that one, but the one standing up there.
Oh.
It'll shoot you down off the ladder, but it didn't notice me, so we're good. And they can't climb, I'm pretty sure. Yeah.
Floats up.
We're getting close to the end of the area. Man, just skipping areas is so useful. Pretty sure we're completely done with shortcuts in the area.
Warm blood gemstone. That means that blood was just freshly put in that gemstone.
Hmm.
Gross.
Especially when you think of it, since it's warm in this environment.
Great.
Great. Copyright PVG 2012. I just got shot with a blow dart from somebody down there because I didn't clear that area out when I went through it. Books! And you go through areas a lot faster when you just skip all the enemies.
Well, yeah, usually.
Okay, I meant to roll there, but... Because there was a roll at the end, so I can't complain.
This looks like a boss area.
It's not. Oh. I don't know what that attack
does.
Why
are his eyes red?
I think... I don't know.
He's evil.
There was a red, eyed werewolf in Old Yharnam, and he poisoned you when he hit you, so I guess he has poison attack. Whoa!
It seems he'd be the only one.
Mm-hmm. He's a special one.
I'm waiting. Bloodstone chunk. Alright, he was probably still digesting that blood then.
Mm-hmm. Run over here. Now this is so unintuitive, it's ridiculous. And this is not a shortcut, this is how you do this. Alright, well, we got nothing left but the boss.
Go around.
Around the boss?
Yes.
Can't, unfortunately. I mean, that's why we're playing this, is for the bosses. Look at my ass.
Yeah, I see a lot of blood coming from it.
Well, I mean, that's not what I... Okay, sure. I'm gonna use wallpaper. Now, you remember Alfred?
The one that kind of gave you information on this stuff?
Yeah, and he also helped us out with the Bloodstar Beast?
Yeah.
And how he was talking about his master, Ligarius. Well, he mentioned his master, Ligarius, who stayed behind when they, fought the Vilebloods in Kanehurst.
Okay.
Well, he didn't die. Also, he's mad at us for some reason. We're about to fight Ligarius.
There's gotta be a reason, though.
This is Alfred's boss.
Treason!
Treason. I'm not even with Alfred, so... I'm a hunter. I'm a completely... I'm a separated
entity.
Well,
no wonder he hates you. You're all warm, and he's all freezing.
Well, I just gotta do what I do. Keep active, man. Be rolling around and stuff. Keep that blood flowing.
Well, now he's trying to be like you, and he figures if he wants to be the best, he's gotta beat the best.
Well... Sorry to say, that's probably not gonna happen. This boss isn't that hard for me. I have died to him. I have gotten stuck on this boss a few times, but usually I can get him on my first try. As long as I focus.
Oh, so he's just the Winter's version of the Reaper.
Sure.
The King Reaper, because he's got a crown.
This guy's got some pretty intense attacks.
Would you say deathly attacks?
Funny that you say that, because a lot of his attacks are skull-based. Oh, that'll follow you. So he's dead. Yeah. Here we go! Can I visceral you? Oh. Now that was not a bad start.
Yeah, that's a quarter of his health gone.
But, his later stages are much harder. Yeah! I've never visceraled him before! That was beautiful. Can I do it again? Oh, what are you doing? Is that an AoE? Eh, okay, bye. Oh.
Oh, wow.
Wow, alright, well. I mean, I'm still doing pretty good. all things considered. Run forward and hit that right now. Hit it. As long as it stays in the ground, swords will rain down from the sky and hit you.
Oh.
Yeah, you want to be wary of that attack. Oh, this attack is easy to dodge. Yeah, this is, like, it's not hard, but it's intense. Oh, crap.
Though he has powerful attacks, they're just kind of slow.
He's also, he's more fast than powerful. He has a couple attacks that are really easy to dodge.
He has really bad accuracy.
Yeah, yeah, that's a well, I mean, he's
either
numb.
Either that or you just move around way too much for him to hit you.
He's really cold. You ever try to play guitar after coming in from the winter and it's all like, I can't do anything with my fingers?
No.
And then your girlfriend gets all mad at you? I may be going a little too deep with this. Anyway, that was probably one of my best fights against him ever. I probably have bolt paper to thank for that.
You defeated death with bolt paper.
Well, we want that crown. Crown of illusions. Now, if you wear that crown and run over here, you will unlock an area. Tiny little area. Now, remember how angry Alfred was when he talked about the Vilebloods. It's clear how much he hates the Vilebloods.
Okay.
We're about to meet the Queen of the Vilebloods.
We just killed the King of the Vilebloods?
No, we killed Alfred's boss. We killed the guy that I suppose was...
So who's the King, then?
I don't think there is one.
I'm just gonna say we killed the King of the Vilebloods, then.
The guy we just fought is against the Vilebloods. The guy we just fought is with Alfred.
Well, there can be kings of many countries that hate their people and their country.
Oh, okay, I suppose.
Well, that escalated quickly.
Yeah. All I know is Ligarius is opposite of Vileblood. Go ahead and take that off now.
Knight's Wig, definitely.
Is it better arcane than this? It is.
Knight's Wig, definitely. Oh, yes. Oh, yeah.
Oh, my. That's... All right.
Flipping so bad.
Let's, is there a flat surface? Right here. Nice. I like it. Now, she is not gonna hurt us, so let's don't worry about that.
I claim no subjects, but here lieth our throne. Kneel afore us, or get thee gone.
Or get thee gone. You're saying get the hell out.
Well, what if I just try to do that?
How sad this is.
Huh.
If only our life was so easily.
So she's immortal. You can't do anything. I'm just gonna go ahead and do what she wants. I'm gonna.
Such impudence.
Oh.
Defiled are we, yet still queen. We shall not give audience to an ill-mannered beast.
You beast.
Alright, I'll do what you want me to do, and I'll kneel.
Or merely lacking in wit.
Eh? This is basically gonna turn me into a vile blood for whatever reason.
Our flesh is undying.
Speak thy mind.
Okay.
Speak thy mind.
Swear oath to the vile.
You tell her to leave, she gets out, you become queen.
I don't know if this makes... I don't know if this makes Alfred hate me or not. Yeah, and a hunter that wants to be a Vileblood? That's weird.
We've tired of these piteous knights. Share in our plight.
Why?
And take oath against the church.
That's okay. I'd rather not.
If thou wouldst this path walk, I prithee partake.
Oh yeah, she gives you a thing. You know what? Never mind. I don't wanna be part of the Vilebloods. Let's get this. It's another Kanehurst summons. Let's take that to Alfred. Say, hey, you know that lady you hate? I know exactly where she is. Let's get this back on.
Can he kill her then?
She's immortal. She cannot die.
Oh. I figured there would be at least one way.
She is not killable. Ah, the throwing knife, one of the Henrik's favorite weapons. Yeah, we found that out.
Hi, hi, hi.
Right, I'm gonna do some upgrading, and then we're gonna go give those to Alfred. That, rather.
Woo!
Yeah. I'm gonna sell Evelyn. Since we're not gonna upgrade Blood Tinge to user.
Okay.
It, rather. And all this numbing mist. Oh, there's a lot of cold blood.
Someone's wrathful spirits?
I've never used it. Why? I can't imagine it's that great. Maybe it is.
I don't know. Can you buy it back?
No. I just lost it. But whatever. I've been in this game several times without it. We're fine. Alright.
That's almost twice as many blood echoes as we had last time.
Alright. That's actually really good. Alright, Alfred. I'm gonna go to the Grand Cathedral? Yeah, it's open. Okay, cool.
He's going way back.
Well, we're gonna go... remember where he was? He was right before the forest. I'm amazed we're able to go to the Grand Cathedral. I thought it was blocked off to us. Apparently not.
Well, alright.
How long are you down for recording for, man?
All night.
Oh, you don't have work tomorrow? Or
tomorrow's Sunday.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I've worked Sundays before and Saturdays.
I only work Monday through Friday unless we're really busy, and then I work Saturdays and Sundays.
Yeah.
Maybe Sundays. It's very iffy on the Sunday because that's only if we're extremely busy and we have to get stuff done.
The weekend doesn't mean much to me because my last job, I usually worked 6 days a week, and my day off was usually like Wednesday.
Okay. Oh, for those in the audience that don't know what I do, I am an agronomy energy operations specialist. I run equipment that requires licenses.
I'm just gonna run past all these assholes. Hey, buddy. I wonder how weak you are now. Wow. Alright.
Okay.
What about this Cthulhu fucker over here? Cool.
Yeah, alright.
Usually they're really tough.
Wait. Wait.
What?
Look.
What?
You didn't see how much health he took down.
A tiny bit? Just tiny amount?
Dude, it wasn't even a 20th of your health.
We're like towards the beginning of the game. Okay, Alfred's right down here. Alfred, I got something for you.
Oh, good to see
Oodles.
You.
He called you a hoe.
Now, let's think.
Well, he's right.
Just tell me what piques your interest.
I got this for you.
Aha. Is that the sigil of Canehurst?
Mm-hmm.
I've heard tell of Canehurst nobles and their amusingly pompous invitations. Wonderful. I thank you profusely.
You're gonna try to go kill her, aren't you?
But first,
token of my gratitude.
Thanks.
I feel my master's hand at work.
He's just talking about his right hand.
I feel my master's hand at work. We just killed him. we literally just killed his master. Alright, well, what he doesn't know won't hurt him.
But without him, we couldn't have gotten to that other dude, lady. The queen.
Mm-hmm.
So without maybe he knows.
About that crown. Alright, so he's leaving to Canehurst right now, so let's go meet up with him. Somehow he gets there before we do.
Let one of them hit you.
Fine.
Yes! Cool. Okay, get out of there. I didn't like how much health they took down.
Oh! Okay! And lamp traveling refills your health, so we're fine.
What?
We're gonna go back to the dream.
Oh, yes.
And then go to Canehurst again. I don't remember which tombstone Canehurst uses.
I thought it was the third one.
I think so. That's the one Yargle uses. So maybe, because there aren't many.
Hello,
Yargle
little boys
decks.
With top hats.
Yeah. Between this session and the next one, unless we record the next session on this day, between this one and the next one, I'll go get the urns.
Okay.
With urns on their heads. Yeah, you were right. The Queen's Chamber. So, Alfred's already there. Somehow he headed us off. How? I wonder how he dealt with her, since she can't die.
And he imprisoned her.
And she's clearly not, like, strong enough to get up and fight.
I've done it. I've smashed, pounded, and grounded this rotten son.
Wow.
She's alive, by the way.
There, you filthy monstrosity. What good's your immortality now? Try stirring up trouble in this...
Now, that's a reference to Pyramid Head from Silent Hill 2.
I was actually about to say that. It looked like it. You're scaring me, Alfred.
What? That's his weapon, by the way. You want to see it in action?
Yes.
All right, well, let's get this first. Cool. He's probably going to kill me, so I'm just going to fight him a little bit.
Why would he kill you?
Because I'm about to hit him. So I'm just going to fight him a little bit, and if it's good, then I'll keep going, but I'm probably just going to run away.
What happens if you win?
That'd be pretty cool. That's not too bad. Uh-oh. That wheel does tons of damage! Really? Because you... Oh! Okay! We're good. I don't think I will.
What's he got on him? Radiance.
What the hell? That's a rune! Is that? It looks like one of the fourth runes. You know how we have three applied normally?
Yes.
Well, there's that fourth one for really special ones. That looked like a special one.
Oh. What?
That's the noise Alfred makes. Oh. All right, let's go find out what that rune is.
That wasn't made to be a reference. Just
I thought it was. Hey, Garmin. Yeah, vile HP. Oh.
It brings in more.
Oh! It makes blood vials more effective.
That's what
They give you more health. Oh! That's awesome!
Why don't you do like one of those lectures? I mean, gestures. I read lectures on there and I was like, where's the.
Yeah!
No, that's no.
Yeah!
Dang it! Yes, no.
Yeah!
Alright, that's fair enough.
And, yeah!
Now just sit down.
Yeah.
Tired from today's work.
Dude, that's awesome. I love the fact that we have that. Okay.
Ready to go.
And remember in Yargul, I dropped into that tiny little cage and got a key.
No.
Well, I did.
The iron key?
No. This was in a recording, in last time's recording session.
Okay.
When we were in Yargul, the area with the respawning enemies.
Ah, yes.
Well, I got a key. I should have talked to Garamond. He tells you, like, very early on, go above Olden Chapel. Just do it. And you try to, but it's locked. In Yargul, we got the key.
Okay.
So we're going to go above. This is the last optional area. And it leads to the hardest boss in the game, man. She's so hard. Oh, yeah! We beat Mikalash. Ariana's gone. Remember how she was holding her stomach in pain last time we saw her?
Yes.
There's a blood trail now. Ariana, you doing okay?
Don't tell me she becomes an enemy.
No, she doesn't. But she does go down here. Why was your stomach hurting? What happened? Ariana, you got a bug or so- Oh. Oh.
What is that?
Alien, baby.
It can't be.
It's cute.
It is. I guess. So yeah, this is what would have happened to Yosefka if we let her live long enough.
Okay.
She wouldn't have given birth, but she would have been, like, in a birthing position.
Oh. Can we kill her now?
You want to?
Well, she's scaring me, and she seems to be in misery. I think it would be a good idea to put her out of it.
I just look laugh crying. Alright.
Ah, yes. Oh, yeah! Smash her. I wonder what would have happened if you just killed the baby.
If you just kill the baby, she dies.
Oh.
I don't know if the baby dies if you just kill her. You got her shoes. Which...
No.
But I get to show off my feminine
Them
legs.
Them white legs, though.
Okay. What are their stats like? Not great. Especially when you compare it to actual armor. Which the doll skirt is not.
No, it's right. Not. One third? Okay.
That's the second one. And the last one you get is basically mandatory. Like, you get it no matter what. So we're good on umbilical cords now. Well, that was fun. Go ahead and use that. Oh, look at my insight. Oh, no. No. I'm
it
not going
12
to
12 last time we went to the Hunter's Dream.
I'm not going to the hardest area in the game with 19 insight. No way, no how. I'm going to buy some stuff. In the insight shop.
At least they made a way that you could get rid of that easily.
Oh my god, I beat the game on my first run with 60.
Oh.
60 insight. Oh, it was awful. Every enemy had... It was... Frenzy was terrible.
Now, do they give you more blood echoes if they have higher insight?
I doubt it. I just bought a crap ton of bolt paper.
I see that.
Alright. Back to what we were doing, which is we're going to above the Odin Chapel.
Above and beyond.
Yes.
Oh man.
By the way, when we record this later, it's episodic, in like 5 episodes.
Okay.
You want
to record it in episodes?
Mm-hmm. And each one can't be over 2 hours long. I almost guarantee you they don't go over 2 hours. So we'll record it by episode, and then I'll split them.
Okay.
We did with Revelations 2.
Okay.
That's how we'll do Telltale Games.
Sweet. Dude, I would definitely be down to play Revelations 2 again also.
I mean, we've done everything that isn't raid mode, so if I'm ever really hurting for something to record, like, I can't think of anything. But right now, my plate is full.
Yeah, we still got tons. We still got to record The Watchmen Part 2 again.
And Beyond Two Souls.
And Beyond Two Souls.
The rest of this. And we have all of Resident Evil. What's happening to me?
The, from when you bought the,
Wow, that lasted a while. Wow. you know what? We're in the right spot. Let's go get the urn now. It's a pretty secret area.
The urn of sacred ashes. Sorry, guys, that was a Dragon Age reference for all you Dragon Age players out there. Rock on!
Secret area. Which leads to...
I think...
Above where we were.
On the top of the church.
Is this the urn or is this something else? Oh, that's a rune. I don't know what it does. It's probably not great. And we got that urn festival.
Just because you don't know what it does, it's all of a sudden not great?
I mean, it's not one of the ones I use. There's no way to keep you from losing that health, by the way. I mean, the ones I use are great. The ones I use are amazing.
I'm curious to see how much a blood vial will restore.
Well, more than what I've got missing right now.
Right.
So I'm gonna wait for a while. Probably not dramatically more, but definitely beneficially more. So last time we went down into that, like, rafter area, where we dropped down until we got to the source of the dream. Now we're going up. This is just sad.
Yes. It's even sadder.
Whoa.
It's even sadder that that first guy missed.
These guys' guns can do quite a bit of damage, actually. So. Especially his.
What would you have done if you fell off?
Oh my god. Can you see any of the great ones from here?
Turn to the right. Okay, those candles out there were sparkling, it looked like.
You. And there's just you left.
Guest.
Saw it. So that door right there is what we got the key to.
Okay. What's in here?
Another badge. What badges do, I think, is they unlock, like, outfits and weapons in the shop.
Okay. Boom. This game has so much more in-depth stuff than you would ever imagine.
Does this thing look familiar to you?
It looks kind of like the another umbilical cord option.
It's those alien babies.
Oh, where's the umbilical cord? Well, Come on.
I mean, there's only four in the entire game. But there are lots of alien babies now. Tons of alien babies in this area.
Man, she gave birth to quite a few.
It wasn't all her. It was just a whole bunch of women. I guess. I'm assuming, otherwise, where else would they have come from? What?
Dogs.
I didn't know you had that attack. I thought that attack came with you, with me having high insight. What's going on here?
Well, it is at the boss level. Use it.
I thought I had my axe. Oh, okay. Oh, okay. All right, I'm just
blood
gonna...
vial.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. So it does about.
I mean,
a third.
It is more, so I can't complain. And it doesn't take the place of any of my other runes, so. Nice.
Ah, oh, very nice.
Another alien, Bebe.
Yes. There's two more. Oh, kill the lizard freaks.
They're so. I don't think they're lizards. I think they're more like slugs. Because they're baby versions of the hardest boss in the entire game, which is essentially a giant slug.
Oh.
The OG alien, one could say. The original.
Ow.
I did, like, nothing. Let me just... There we go. That's...
Yes. Oh my gosh.
That was nice. That was okay.
I can see why you use that weapon over that other one.
Well, the axe is fortified more than the hammer.
Oh, okay.
And it has better,
It has a little bit better range.
Also, better blood gems attached to it. Because with blood gems, the cleaver gets the best ones, then the axe, then the hammer.
Okay.
And then the gun. Damn. Love it.
One more. Yes.
Oh, you're dead.
He was still in the process of dying.
Yeah. And we're coming up on an area that has some pretty tough werewolves in it, actually. I'm gonna, for the most part, cheat the game. Like, use a doorway. Okay. No more crows. We got one more gravekeeper upstairs.
Who draped all these blankets over here?
Right?
Think of how useful that could be.
Oh man, when I recorded the series for YouTube, I accidentally ran right into that fire.
And?
It hurt me a little bit. I was just upset with myself for doing it. I'm glad I timed that right. Oh, I just remembered. There's a lot of Cthulhu fuckers in here.
He'll make it. Aw, the poor guy. He's bowing his head to the... mind.
Okay, we're fine. Okay.
Shaman Bone Blade?
And I only have two insight, so I can't really let them grab me.
Why?
They take insight away. And you need some insight to be able to upgrade and stuff.
Oh. Get your torch out.
And how am I doing on... Yeah, I don't have any Madman's Knowledge. Well, surprise, through the window, there's some. Hey, buddy.
Hey, werewolf with blue eyes.
And we can't go through that door.
I see the,
lock from the other side.
Can you hit him from here? Like, with your axe?
I highly doubt it. so close. It's like making him move. That would be amazing. No. Because I really hate dealing with them, and there's quite a few of them in this building. This building is probably my least favorite in the game. It's, like, not boring-wise, that's probably Kanehurst, but it's just...
frustrating?
Oh, yeah, because there's just some parts, little parts, where you can just really get screwed over. Ah, crap. Chandelier werewolves.
Ah, I see them.
You do? I don't see them yet.
I see them.
Oh, I see one. Yeah.
There's two of them on there. One on the lower, one on the upper.
Yeah, I see. It's gonna go over here.
Sections.
Alright. I don't seem all that interested. Alright, fine, I'll go this way first. Where's the Cthulhu from? There he is. Is he facing away?
Yes.
Oh. Alright, well. Here we go with this crap. I'm actually gonna go down from the other side because I'm gonna
hit
run
him with
back.
Pebbles?
Oh, they'll come towards me. Okay, here we go.
They
to
broke
the door,
the chandelier.
Uh oh. Okay, to the door. Alright.
You had plenty of time.
These guys are strong. Oh, wow.
They don't seem that strong.
Again, grinding helps. They hit hard, though. Like, this is one of the roughest. this is one of the roughest areas in the game. For me. Where the alright. Can I do this? Can I use my axe against you guys? Hey. Yeah. Uh-oh. Okay, alright.
That worked out very well.
Alright. Uh-oh.
No.
Back to the cleaver. I'm just gonna let you attack and then I'll attack.
Strategy.
That helps a lot for the dogs, too. Just back up until they attack. Okay,
well,
no more werewolves.
These are dogs, in a sense.
Yeah. They are of the canine
just
variety.
Not domesticated.
Okay, I'm just gonna wait for him to come over here.
Patience, my young warrior.
Yep. Seriously, these guys are rough to deal with. I hate the Cthulhu fuckers so much.
And just now we just started hearing his footsteps.
Why not Zoidberg? Are you gonna walk out here or are you gonna turn around? Turn around.
I think he knows you're there.
Fuck this. Uh-oh. Okay. That's not a good idea, but, like...
it's a good thing your stamina's up high enough that you can hit him 4 times rather than just 3.
Oh, man, on New Game Plus... okay, let's look at my stats now. Where is it?
Stamina 93?
It's at 11.
What is 11?
Endurance. See?
Bottom
left.
Now I see it. Okay.
On my New Game Plus, it's at 40.
Oh.
Because I hit the hard caps. Not hard caps, but I hit the caps for health and damage and all that. So I bumped
that
up.
So you just bumped that up too.
So I can hit them so many times, which is good because I need... there's another werewolf. What? I don't remember you. You were too patient.
You're not in the nightmare, are you?
No. This is a real area.
Okay. Now they're still losing 16 gallons of blood every time you hit them.
I mean, that's just because it's Bloodborne. That's just because that's what kind of game it is. Alright, there's a few Cthulhu fuckers left. Is there one down there? Oh, this is a trap. That bonus buddy right there is a trap. Do not fall for it. Who gives a shit? It's just stone sh- oh, I guess. Right, if you're gonna run towards me, then sure, I'll hit you. But, yeah, there's you.
Hit him through the wall.
There that. Okay. Uh-oh. Okay, we're good. Yeah. There's like 4 more in the building, I think. Oh, I should have kept some blue elixir.
You know, for this game and you saying this is the hardest place, you're progressing very well.
I've been through this many times. Yeah, I've lost to this place many times. Oh man, should I try to charge him? And dodge his attacks to get, because I'm impatient.
No. Hey man, it's just however you want to do it.
No, let's be patient and wait for him. Now he will keep walking past this door. He doesn't turn around. So like when he's in the door frame, we want to.
Can you visceral him?
I don't have time. He's too fast. Okay, now try. Okay, we're good. All right. This is Madman's knowledge, I think. No. Oh, blue elixir.
That's blue elixir.
I need
nice.
That.
Blindfold cap. Kind of curious about this.
It's arcane is 70. That's arcane.
I think it's the Got best the, arcane out of all of them.
It is the best arcane. So we'll keep that for the boss of this area.
And there's your madman's knowledge.
Yeah. By the way, this area has two bosses in a row. The first one's not that hard. Wait, what was it that I just picked up? I wasn't paying
purse
attention.
Slug.
Okay. I wasn't paying attention.
I'm glad I was.
Okay. I think we've got three Cthulhu fuckers left.
Yeah, because you said there was four before you went up that ladder.
There's one, you can see that one right there?
Yeah.
And then that one right there? I'm pretty sure there's one in there.
What are you gonna do? Drink drugs?
Now, this doesn't make you invisible. Like, they still notice me for whatever reason, but this is, I mean, a little bit helps.
It seemed to work out for you.
It makes it easier for me to sneak up behind him.
Oh yeah, I forgot you had that one that give you viscerals when you were... It gave you health when you had viscerals.
No, no. Yeah, it's pretty great. Ah, and we got the orphanage key. That's what we needed.
Grand.
Is there anything in here? I shouldn't just open the door, but I'm excited that I got the key. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, this All is right. that one that you were trying to hit from in there. That would have made this go so much faster if you could just go through right there.
Right? Like, you have a giant axe. Maybe use it? Okay. Ah. Make contact. And we use that to get the best moon rune from the giant brain. But first, let's finish this area.
Have you ever seen any of the Crackdown games?
I've seen a couple videos on Crackdown 2.
Okay. Crackdown 3 is going to come out here soon. I don't remember the date. But I'm really excited. I saw a preview of it.
Nice.
Or, I guess it was just a trailer of it. Dude, it was awesome.
I'm looking for the door the orphanage key goes to. Oh, I went full circle. Alright, well, let's go downstairs. I don't remember. Wait. Actually, is it in here? No. Okay, let's go downstairs. We'll end this session really soon. And then if you want, we can just, like, finish up right away with the next section. Because I bet you anything, we're definitely under 2 hours away from beating the game.
Okay. Why don't we, after this episode, we'll do these two, or this game real quick.
It's kind of a long game. We'll do episode one of that.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
All right. You know what? Screw it. Let's do a boss. This next area, the end of this area is, I know. But okay. This area is two bosses in a row. Let's do the first one of those two bosses.
Okay.
Just to make the end of this episode not boring.
I guess you can edit it down.
I'm not going to. Oh. But let's give this episode a climax, you know? Aliens? What are the aliens doing in this area?
Don't give away hints. I mean, you can, I suppose.
Hopefully, there aren't any more aliens in the air. Oh!
Yeah, and then there's the big one with all the giant things coming out of his head.
It's one of these. I have to find out which one it is. Okay, it's the one that's not trying to attack me. It's you. He's not really tough. Not overly strong.
Except for now.
Well, I mean, even now, it's not that big of a deal. Oh, unless I die. Okay.
Very nice.
Beat the boss. Communion.
What's communion?
It's a better communion rune. I can hold 4 vials instead of when I use that rune anyways, which that's only really I'm gonna use that for the last boss. Activate this lamp and then we're done for the session.
Alrighty.
So yeah, we're not too far over 2 hours. Alright, well, we'll see you guys in the next one, which is probably gonna be the last one. Hold on.
We hope.
Hold on. Later.
Yeah.
Go ahead.